and all the people say you can't wake up, this is not a dream. Your part is a machine, you are not a human being. We should say so mean all living on a screen.
Dennis, I'm gonna do my first initial flight of the GoPro Karma drone. I got a Hero 7 Black here. We shall see how it goes. I just updated the firmware on the drone, the gimbal, and the controller. The Hero 7 is already updated, so I'm hoping that works out. So let's take a look. I'm gonna be flying it over there. All right, bye. I'm gonna turn this on. Let's go ahead and start the controller. Starting motors. And then there he goes. Rotate it around. Hey! Go up! Finding where it was launched at, and I guess it's trying to find its spot. Woo! That was pretty awesome. All right, guys. So that was my first initial flight with the Karma drone. It worked pretty well. I didn't fly it for too long because I'm not sure if I'm actually allowed to fly here. But it was a big open space, and I didn't fly it too high. There are some auto shot paths on it that we'll test another time, but so far I'm pretty pleased with it. Okay, so I decided to find another spot to do more testing because I wanted to do some of the auto flight paths. So I found this really big open space. And not too many trees, so I'm just gonna stay away from the trees on the outer edges. But I'm gonna do it here, see what we get. Start it.
3, 2,
starting the motors.
One.
Motors are on. Trying to take off. There we go. So it's up in the air right now. And it's doing a pretty good job hovering. It's kind of windy right now. Bye, Karma.
Are you insane like me? Been in pain like me? Bought $100 bottle of champagne like me? Just to pour that motherfucker down the drain like me? Would you use your water bill to dry the stain like me? Are you high enough without the Mary Jane like me? Do you tear yourself apart to entertain like me? Do the people whisper about you on the train like me? Saying that you shouldn't waste your pretty face like me. And all the people say,
you can't wake up, this is not a dream. Your blood is a machine, you are not a human being. We should say so, man up, living on a screen. Blow our self-esteem, so you run on gasoline.
Hey guys, so that was my first two flights for my Karma drone. So far I really like what it's capable of. I didn't get to do all the auto flight paths. I'll test those another time. It was kind of windy, and the area that I thought was pretty big wasn't as big as I thought, so there were trees there, and having the houses along the other side kind of hindered it. I didn't want to fly it too high and have people kind of be nosy and maybe call the cops on me. Yeah, because I'm not too familiar with the laws yet. So I've been trying to kind of fly it kind of low-key, keeping it not too high, not trying to attract any attention to myself. But what I saw so far was really good. I liked it. I plan on flying it more and getting a little bit more practice. It's really easy to set up. Like I said, this morning I basically updated the firmware, and then got it flying, not even an hour later. And then I took it to a second spot and then flew it. So, I'm really glad that it has follow me mode. I guess that was included in the firmware update. I'll try the orbit, the cable cam, and the droney, another time. I really want to get used to flying the controller when it's inverted and I'm facing one way and the camera is facing a totally different direction and I'm trying to go forward and I end up going the wrong way. That can get kind of confusing, but it was pretty stable. I know a lot of people complain about it constantly drifting, and I'm not sure if maybe that was just fixed with the firmware update or not, but what I experienced was pretty stable. It was pretty windy. It wasn't bad. I mean, if it was bad, I probably wouldn't be trying to fly a drone anyways, but it held its own. The only thing I noticed is when it's hovering, sometimes it's pretty stable and it'll stay at its spot, the right altitude, but then sometimes I would see it kind of drop down a little bit, and I don't know if that's because of the wind or if it's a power thing. I'm not really sure. So I think just keep an eye on that. You don't want it to auto land. I think that might be the thing. Maybe it's stagnant for so long at one level that it decides like, oh, maybe I should land as a safety measure. I'm not sure. This is not a review. It's basically my reactions to it upon first couple of flights. Like I said, so far it's really awesome. I like it. I can't wait to fly it more. When I go on different trips, I can't wait to bring it along. I am going to San Francisco this weekend, but I don't think I have the skills to take it there and fly it with a heavily populated city. I might hurt someone or myself or get in trouble. So that's a no-no. So I'm going to practice a little bit more. I might take you guys along. But like I said, thumbs up, actually double thumbs up. I like the fact that I can use my Hero 7. But yeah, so far my initial reaction is this thing is awesome. It's in the back. This thing is really awesome. I like it. I'm super pumped. I'm happy with it. I'm sure there are better drones out there. And you know, for sure there's better drones out there. But I will never buy another DJI drone just because their customer service sucked and for some reason it was supposed to be super simple and the setup was not super simple, and that was irritating. Karma Drone, super awesome. I can't wait to use it more. I have the grip, but I have to update that. I thought when I was updating the gimbal in the updates, I thought it was actually the grip, but I think the grip I have to do separately. I have to sync it up to, I have to download the app, the quick desktop app or something. I have to download that to my computer, and I have to plug the grip into my computer, which I didn't know. I assumed when it said the gimbal on the controller update, I thought it was updating the gimbal itself, including the grip. But I guess the grip has its own separate controls, so that's understandable. So I'll do that tonight, and then I don't know if I'll take the gimbal, the Karma grip, I don't know if I'll take that with me to San Francisco, because I really don't need one, because I have my Hero 7 Black, so I don't think I'll actually need it. So I'll use that for something else, for when I want to do some really cool filming. But they market the Karma drone as being so much more than a drone, and that's true. I love the fact that, like I said, you can take the camera out. A lot of drones have a built-in camera, and that's it. If it's raining or you need to go underwater, your drone with your expensive fancy camera in there is basically a paperweight. You can't do anything with it. With the GoPro Karma, you can take out your camera, use it as a camera on the ground. You can take out the gimbal, put it in the Karma grip, and you have a stabilizer. I do like the Karma drone. I am satisfied with it so far. I'm sure it'll give me really cool, buttery smooth, epic footage from the sky in the future. It is fun to fly. The controller does make it seem like you're playing a game, video game of some sort. But yeah, it's two thumbs up. A-okay. I can't wait to shoot more with it. All right, bye guys, that's it. I will see you next time. Bye.